COVID-19 ने हमारी रोजमर्रा की जिंदगी को काफी असरअंदाज किया है. सो मच सो दैट वी हैव टू रीअसेस वेरी बेसिक सिंपल थिंग्स इन आवर लाइव्स लाइक गोइंग आउट टू बाय ग्रोसरीज. तो इमेजिन करें वो खवातीन जो प्रेग्नेंट हैं, उनके अपने हेल्थ से रिलेटेड और आने वाले बच्चे की हेल्थ से रिलेटेड कितने सारे कंसर्न्स होंगे. आज मदर्स डे है और हम उन सारी माओं का शुक्रिया अदा करना चाहते हैं जिन्होंने हमारे लिए बहुत कुछ किया. बट एट द सेम टाइम हम उनको भी एक्नॉलेज करना चाहते हैं जो नई माएँ हैं, जो नई जिंदगी इस दुनिया में ला रही हैं, उनके क्या क्या कंसर्न्स हैं. द बायर वुमेन्स हेल्थ केयर टीम हैज़ कोलैबोरेटेड विद द रेनाउंड गायनेकोलॉजिस्ट डॉक्टर सैयदा बतूल मजहर टू एड्रेस ऑल दीज इशूज एंड कंसर्न्स. तो आइए चल के एक छोटी सी इंफॉर्मेटिव वीडियो देखते हैं. Data that we have so far, the pregnant women do not appear to be more likely to contract this infection as compared to the general population. However, pregnancy itself alters the body immune system, and we know from its response to various viral conditions, we've seen even influenza sometimes progressing very rapidly in the advanced pregnancies. So there is this little cause of concern that pregnancy is a state in which the immune response is a little different. So there is a cause of concern, especially after 28 weeks, what we call as the last trimester, यानी जो आखिरी तीन महीने होते हैं उसमें हमें फिक्र ज़्यादा है कि उसका कोई इन्फ्लुएंस बच्चे पे ज़्यादा ना हो. And it has not been shown to be teratogenic. So if a woman contracts a COVID infection and recovers from it in her first 3 months, there has been no document that it causes any abnormality in the fetus. So I would advise all women who are in their advanced pregnancy to be extra careful with all the instructions that we give, which is basically washing their hands for at least 20 seconds with soap and water thoroughly. And basically social distancing, avoiding lots of crowds. Yes, pregnancy is a state in which we want to maintain health, and you do not necessarily have to be very sick to see a doctor in pregnancy. It is a state of health and we want to maintain that state of health. However, I would advise, because in the current situation with lockdowns in progress, we would not advise them, if they have no significant risk factors, to seek routine follow-ups from hospitals where OPDs are closed. So in low-risk pregnancies, ideally we should be doing regular follow-ups, but due to overcrowding and the risk to the women who are pregnant, once they go to a health facility and if there is crowding, the risk of contracting corona is very high, as well as transmitting is very high. So if it's a low risk pregnancy, I would advise women to use the social media for seeking care. So there are hospitals who are running teleclinics. There are hospitals which are doing video clinics, so there are helplines available. So I would advise women to seek this care, so that if they feel that there is something not right, then they should appropriately seek care. Strongly advise, do not go to a public hospital, because public hospitals cater to healthy patients. If you have suspicion of corona, you're not very sick, self-isolate, and if you recover in 7 days, you are generally fine, and within 2 weeks to 4 weeks you will no longer be infective to others. If you have somebody in your home who has a COVID infection, I would recommend that you should basically isolate from that person as well, and then for another 2 weeks do not get out of the house and expose other people to the same infection. Whatever limited data we have, it is not associated with higher risk of a miscarriage. And there have been some reports in previous epidemics of SARS एंड मर्स जो कि इससे रिलेटेड कोरोना वायरसेस हैं जो कि आज से 2-4 साल पहले फैले हैं कुछ मुल्कों में. सो दे वर सम प्री टर्म बर्थ्स बट वी डोंट नो वेदर दे वर इनिशिएटेड ड्यू टू द वुमन बीइंग इल और इट हैपन्ड ड्यू टू दिस पर्टिकुलर डिजीज. सो वी आर होपिंग दैट वी विल नॉट बी सीइंग मच प्रॉब्लम्स. Whatever general data we are getting, reported data, the risk of vertical transmission, although it is theoretically there, it has not really been found in a big way. And if the woman has active COVID infection and she delivers, then she should be advised that she can breastfeed her baby. But the precaution is that she must wear a mask and she must wash her hands for 20 seconds, at least 20 to 30 seconds with soap and water. And so that the baby is protected from her respiratory secretions. The breast milk has not been so far known to transmit COVID infection to the baby, but the resistance that the baby gets from that breast milk is tremendous. So I would advise all the pregnant women who have suspected COVID, who are suffering from COVID or otherwise, they should continue breastfeeding, but use the principles of this particular pandemic of using a face mask and washing their hands. That is the most important principle. If the woman is unwell and she has serious illness and she has delivered recently, then expressed breast milk remains an option if it is collected hygienically. Is that another recommendation going on? Should we be giving somebody else's milk? If there's another mother in the family who's breastfeeding, should she be asked to breastfeed this newborn? That is an option, but nowadays with that risk of hepatitis and HIV, it is not routinely recommended. एक और बहुत ज़रूरी सवाल कि आजकल के ज़माने में जब हर तरफ कोरोना फैला हुआ है, तो उस दौरान जब हमारे पास कोई मरीज़ अगर लेबर में आ जाए जो कि सस्पेक्टेड कोरोना डिजीज़ हो या वो एक्चुअली उसको कोरोना प्रोवन हो, अभी तक हमारे पास जो ख़वातीन आई हैं जो अभी तक डिलीवर भी हुई हैं वो सस्पेक्टेड कोरोना थी और उनके ऐसे अलामत थी कि हमने सोचा कि ये कोरोना ही होगा और हमने उसके लिए अपने हॉस्पिटल में, जिस हॉस्पिटल में मैं काम करती हूँ, हमने एक SOP बनाई है. SOP का मतलब है स्टैंडर्ड ऑपरेटिंग प्रोसीजर. सो वेन एवर द पेशेंट कम्स इन, दे आर अलर्टेड दैट दिस इज़ अ सस्पेक्टेड कोरोना पेशेंट एंड शी इज़ टेकन टू एन आइसोलेशन एरिया where she is seen by doctors and nurses who are wearing the proper PPE, which is the personal protective equipment. The care of the patient with COVID or suspected COVID in labor is practically the same. So we give the same care to these women and the same obstetric procedures will be carried out with these women. However, the most important part is the moment such a patient enters the hospital, she should be made to wear a mask and she should be isolated and kept in a separate room or a separate ward from the general patients who are in labor. Similarly, if there is a delivery which has to be take place, ideally it should be all done within that restricted space. The number of staff should be restricted to as minimum as required and they would need full personal protective equipment including N95 mask, face shield and the proper Tyvek suit that is needed. Similarly, if that patient needs a cesarean section, he should be operated in a separate theater, and if you cannot possibly do that, then once she is taken to that theater, it is declared as a COVID positive theater and all staff that will go to that theater, including the anesthetist, the surgeon, obstetrician, the neonatal person, the operation technician, the anesthesia technician and the scrub nurse, they have to wear high level personal protective equipment and the disposal of that particular would be according to COVID positive disease. And once that procedure is over, if the patient is stable, she can be transferred to a proper corona ward, where whichever is available in that particular hospital, and she should be nursed in that place. However, with suspected corona patients, you have to keep them in the isolation ward till their report comes back as positive or negative, and then you take appropriate action. woman who has suffered from COVID-19? What are the long-term consequences? We really don't know. We don't have enough data. It's too short a time. There are some theoretical risks of lung dysfunction, chronic lung disability in survivors, but we really don't know. I would strongly advise people not to plan a pregnancy in these uncertain times of pandemics, when the health facilities are overburdened with all sorts of very seriously sick patients and the risk of contracting COVID to the mother. So I would advise that planned pregnancies should not be done at this time. And moreover, the fertility societies, the IVF federations, the FIGO, they have all issued statements which they are saying that patients should be avoiding pregnancies at this time. And if they are seeking fertility treatments, they should discontinue all fertility treatments wherever possible. So I would like to wish all the people who are listening to this particular talk, keep safe, keep yourself protected from this particular coronavirus by practicing the principles of hygiene, and that is wear a face mask, keep social distancing of 3 to 6 feet from other people, and repeatedly washing your hands with soap and water, because contact with different surfaces can give your hands that infection. And if you touch your nose, eyes or mouth with those hands which have been contaminated by dirty secretions or the dirt which is carrying that virus, you're likely to get infected.